Welcome to the Nightly News. I'm your host, Chia Shong.
And I'm Jamie Herdina. Well, homeschooling week is over and everyone seems to be calming down a bit.
They sure are, Jamie. With all the excitement last week, everyone was swept up in the wave of school spirit and a good time was had by all.
The dance was so much fun. I've never had so much fun at a dance before.
I will certainly agree with you on that. The DJ was awesome, the lights, the music, and the overall appearance of the students was extraordinary.
And with that, let's take a look at all the events that happened last week.
Here at the 1999 edition of the Powder Puff Game.
Gentlemen, welcome to Knight's Field in Oak Creek.
It's homecoming night and the crowd is pumped up.
Your own dream lands.
Nobody knows it, but you've got a secret smile, and you use it only for me. Nobody knows it, but you've got a secret smile, and you use it only for me.
So use it
and prove it, remove this whirling sadness. I'm losing. But you can save me from madness.
Nicole, 30.
received by me only. Nobody knows it but you.
Catherine Villarreal escorted by Madman.
Only for me. Nobody knows it but you. Got a secret smile and you use it only for me. So use it and prove it. Remove this.
Dean Wojak escorted by Kristen.
Nobody knows it, but you've got a secret smile.
Lauren, you may now crown the king.
Well, homecoming week looked like a lot of fun, but it takes a lot of hard work to prepare for it. Student Council was in charge of homecoming festivities this year.
Without them, the fun activities last week would not have happened. And this year, there's a new Student Council advisor.
Here is Jamie's interview with Ms. Schmaltz.
Hello. Welcome. Today, we are going behind the scenes to see who organizes all the fun, new, and exciting events here at our school. Do you know who this is? Well, Ms. Schmaltz and the Student Council have been working very hard these past few weeks. Let's see what Ms. Schmaltz has to say about what has been going on. Hello. How does this year's Student Council differ from last year's?
Well, to start off with, we have new members, and we have a new advisor, that would be me, and Ms. Otto's here from last year. It's in the process of a lot of change. We're trying to make it a more visible student council, a more involved student council, and because of this change, this year will be the year that we try a lot of things to see what will work. We're going to start out by doing a conference, coming up on November 4th, to talk to other high schools that have student councils and learning from them what our role should be.
Well, you really
want to
succeed, and how is it going?
It was a huge success. Because I wasn't involved last year, it's hard for me to really compare, but I'm basing my comments on what I've heard from other people, and that is that our attendance at the dance was at a record high. We're estimating 800 to 1,000 people at the dance, based on our ticket sales. It was also a success in that, compared to what I've heard from the previous years, as far as student council being involved in the whole setting it up and decorating, we had a lot more participation in that aspect of student council.
Okay.
That's about it.
Okay.
Yeah.
About how many people are on student council this year? Like, who's students are involved?
We have approximately 40, 10 per grade.
Do you get any, like, people that just say, I want to help out with this, like volunteers, like on this?
We can have that type of help. Yeah, and I have, actually. And in fact, I was reading through some student council information. We have a handbook that we got from the Wisconsin Association of Student Councils, and they recommend getting as many students involved as possible. So we had extra kids help.
So even if
with,
they're not on?
Yeah, they helped with the decorating, and then a number of the committees that we're going to set up to accomplish certain tasks can also have not only student council members, but anybody that wants to participate. So we'll take whatever help we can get.
How do you get on student council? Like, what do you have to do to be accepted?
There are certain requirements in our constitution for what needs to be met, although we're in the process of working out the constitution, fine-tuning that also. So that's probably going to change. For this year, it was based primarily on interest, and I felt that given that we had the elections at the beginning of the year, it was real difficult to get the word out. I don't think as many people knew about it as could have or should have. So that'll be changing. We want to change the elections to the spring so that we have our representatives already in place before the school year begins. And then we'll have more of an opportunity to get the word out and let people participate that really want to.
Okay. What is the next major event that student council is sponsoring or planning?
Oh, we have yet to decide that, but in the past, it depends on what you consider a major event.
Like the winter formal?
Yeah, there is going to be probably some kind of winter dance, and that'll be up to our current student council to decide that. But we also do a lot of community service type activities, and I'm sure that we will again do a food drive either in November or December, and various activities like that. But as far as the dance, it would be the winter dance, whatever that's going to be.
How will student council be more involved with the students this year? Like getting them to participate? Like, ideas, how to draw their attention?
No. I think our first goal in regards to that is making our current student council more visible and letting everyone know that we're out there doing what we're supposed to do. I'd like to eventually have it announced at assemblies who our student council members are so the entire school can see who's on student council. That way, the school will be more involved in that. They'll know who's on council and they'll know who to go to. Because right now, I don't think a lot of people know. They might hear the name, but not put the name and the face together. So I think visibility is probably our number one way of getting that goal accomplished.
Okay. Thank you for your time.
Thanks, Jordan.
Okay, all in all, this year's student council will be much more involved with our students. Now back to the desk.
She has a lot of fun and unique ideas planned for student council, so we should all have high expectations this year for student council planned activities.
I most certainly agree with that. It looks like the student council is better than ever this year. Now, Chio, what do you think what would you do with $1 million?
Well, first I would buy a home in Tampa Bay and then I'd invest the rest. What about you, Jamie?
Well, first of all, I would buy a purple Camaro Z28. Then I would invest in the stock market, buy some jewelry, and then maybe a penthouse in Manhattan.
What would you do?
This week at Oak Creek High School for our opinion poll, we decided to find out exactly what Oak Creek High School students and faculty would do with $1 million. Let's see what some of them had to say.
$15.
I would buy a nice car and a nice wardrobe. I'd probably take all my friends shopping or something. I'd make my mom do the whole new wardrobe. She has.
What would I do with $1 million? I'd buy 1 million candy bars.
School or something.
I'd buy the school.
Yeah. Spend it all on Teresa.
Hand over to me.
Buy me a big mansion. Viper. I have no clue. That's about it.
I would spend it on anything that I ever wanted. Car. Anything.
I've always wanted to go sailing out in the Mediterranean. I think I'd go do that. Go get a big old sailboat, like the ones with the antique sails and stuff. And like, I'd go buy one of them that you can live on. Buy a fat computer for it. Never leave my boat. Go stay, just sail everywhere for the rest of my life with $1 million.
I would do with $1 million, sell my house, build a new one, buy a new car so I wouldn't have to drive my Toyota Corolla 1991 hoopty, and buy Mr. Hoover a new snowmobile. That's what I would do with $1 million.
A car, and pay back all the money I owe to other people. Be nice and give money to my parents, because they need money for their car payments, and I'd go shopping. A shopping spree is what any other girl, I think.
Buy myself a big mansion.
Let's see. Buy a car.
And
no, just because mine doesn't work.
And
I don't know.
It's a lot of money. Not have a job for a while. And I'd invest in like stocks and stuff and get more money.
Some of it to charity. I would buy a new car. I would buy some new clothes. And the rest of it I would save for college.
I would invest it in my college fund.
Buy a whole box.
I would buy a car and then donate the rest of the money to charity.
I would buy a house in Hawaii, a cabin up north, and a nice ass car.
Pay off all my bills, quit working, spend a lot of money, and make sure my kids get a good college education.
If I had $1 million, I would help everybody out. I wouldn't keep it to myself. I'd help the poor people out, help a school. I'd get us a new school.
I'd have a really good time.
Okay, with $1 million, I think I would probably go to a small town and I would invest in opening a church, probably an Assembly of God, because that's where I go and it's really good. And the congregation is good, but we also have disadvantages where people can't make it there because of the location of the church. So I'd probably go to a small town and start the congregation there. And as the town grows, more than likely, because that's probably what will end up happening, hopefully the congregation, the size of the people that attend, will grow as well. And I would probably just invest that $1 million in a small church instead of something big, because I probably won't have enough money to make it big. So that's probably what I would do.
I would travel the world. I would also donate a portion of it to Oak Creek High School to update their computer labs. And I'd also invest some of it wisely.
Buy a car?
I don't know.
I don't know. We got something nice, like charities or something. But you know, we'd buy clothes and stuff too. And then what else would we buy? What would I do?
I'd buy a car.
House,
no, I'd buy a car. A new car. A 2008.
Thanks a lot.
Hi, Kristen.
Sure. Buy a yellow car.
Pay some bills, go on a vacation, save to be old and retired.
If I had $1 million, I'd be rich, so I'd buy like a big house and a big car, and I'd buy everybody something.
Those were a lot of good answers. Back to you.
Thanks, Matt and Mike. It seems like most students would rather buy things with their money rather than invest it. which is very materialistic. On the other hand, the adults would want to invest rather than spend.
Kind of, you know, long-term thinking by the adults. But, you know, this is high school, so students, it's normal for students to want to spend and want more than to invest in their futures. Go ahead.
A tradition here at Oak Creek has been for the students to yell "Knights" during the national anthem at any of our sporting events.
The administration has asked the student body not to do this anymore. Whether you agree or disagree with this plea from our school principal is up to you.
For those of you who come to watch the Oak Creek football team play, you've probably heard the controversy about yelling "Knights" during the national anthem. We talked to students and parents about what they had to say about yelling of the Knights. What is your opinion about yelling "Knights" during the national anthem?
I think we should be able to say "Knights," and that's my opinion, and that's what I'm sticking to, and that's all I have to say.
Thank you.
So true that we do not show enough respect to veterans and all the people that have been through that. I don't care about the other schools. I don't care if we tick them off, but, you know, it's so disrespectful to the veterans. So, yeah.
I think it's okay. I don't think it's disrespectful at all, and I don't think they have any right to tell us that we can't do it.
I think it's a good tradition. If the students want to yell "Knights" in the national anthem, I think you should let them.
Saying "Knights" during national anthem is cool because it sounds really neat. And it's really nice to say, okay.
Anything the matter with that? Because it's just school spirit. And it gets the crowd riled up for the football games.
Damn, why we can't.
Respectful for the people singing it and like the world.
I really don't think there's no disrespect meant when a team's doing it. I think it's just tradition that was started at the games, and I think it's all in good spirits.
I think it's a true showing of school spirit. It really doesn't bother me at all. I've seen a lot worse things during a national anthem. I think it's great.
I think that the way the team has been, I think that the fans really support the team, and I think if the team did not want the fans saying it, all they'd have to do is tell them that, and I think the fans would listen to what the team has to say.
Thank you.
Well, all honesty, I don't think it's the thing to do because it really doesn't pertain to our Oak Creek Knights. The Star Spangled Banner is the song of our country, and it should be respected as that.
In my opinion, yelling "Knights" during the national anthem is a good thing and should continue because it's showing school spirit. Just be glad that we're not yelling it during out-of-school activities. Back to the desk.
Go ahead.
Interesting. Great job, Jesse and Courtney.
Well, Jamie, our Oak Creek Knights football team are undefeated.
That's right, and on October 1st, they beat South Milwaukee 50-0. Here are some highlights from the homecoming football game.
50-8.
Sorry, 15-8.
50-8. We'll be right back.
On my clock, 1, 2, 3,
okay, here's the Warren Whiskey Championship. I've always said this. Big games come down to players making plays in a big game. You have to have players making plays. I'll tell you what. Tomorrow.
I'm sorry about the score before. It was actually 50-8, not 0. But who pays attention to the score anyways? Because the games are so fun and exciting, we all know that the Knights are always going to win.
Exactly, Jamie. And I think something that the Knights, their fans, and Jamie and I will agree with is that if you haven't attended an Oak Creek Knight football game, then you should go to one because you don't know what you're missing.
Well, that's our show for today.
Tune in next week when our special guest will be none other than Stone Cold Steve Austin of the WWF. Just kidding. But anyways, really though, tune in next week for another episode of
The Nightly News.
Bye-bye, kids.